Next on Fox, U.S. troops are pouring into Haiti as the expected death toll now nears a staggering 200,000. But amid the death and destruction, signs of life. Rescue crews found two survivors in a collapsed supermarket yesterday. Meanwhile, looting has become another major problem. Hundreds breaking into shops in Port-au-Prince, taking whatever they can find. Their item of choice? Toothpaste to smear under their noses to fend off the stench of decaying bodies. And at this hour, Fox 2's Roche Madden is aboard a humanitarian flight from Scott Air Force Base that is due to arrive in Haiti at any time.
In a Fox 2 exclusive, he shows us how the huge load of work is lightened by many hands.
It's a round-the-clock job getting much-needed food and medical supplies to Haiti. In the darkness of night, crews at Scott Air Force Base load a C-17 with some 40,000 pounds of cargo, including a Humvee. They secure everything tight. Once airborne, shifting cargo could quickly put the plane out of balance, tilting dangerously toward the tail or the nose. The results could be disastrous.
It could smash out the back, out the front. It could be fatal if we don't get it secured.
A C-17 can carry more than 170,000 pounds of cargo and people, and then a full tank of gas can fly for some 12 hours.
Our job is to take care of patients in the air, whether they're wounded soldiers or whether they're injured and sick people from Haiti.
The flight nurse is accompanied by boxes and boxes of medical supplies. Even the Humvee will be used for injured earthquake victims.
It's more than just a Humvee. There's a lot of equipment and supplies in that vehicle.
From the pilots to the medical personnel to the people who load the cargo, all are grateful to be part of such an important mission.
We all realize that they need a lot of help right now, and we're able to give that to them.
We're all excited about doing it. We wanted to come here. We heard we had the opportunity, so we jumped at the opportunity to go down there and help out.
We have a job to do, and we're going to get the job done.
That was Roche Madden, and we hope to hear from Roche as soon as he lands in Haiti, so keep it on Fox 2 to watch his reports. And